Hello everyone, thank you for joining me for some really late afternoon tea. Today we're gonna dive deep into the topic of voting, which I know we talk about all the time, but there are so many ways you can vote this year and these deadlines are really fast approaching. So it's important that we get this information into our brains and use it to the best of our ability. But before I get up on my soapbox, let's show off what I'm munching on. This week I made chocolate chip cookies because who doesn't love a good old American classic? And today I'm sipping on Flying Rhino coffee again because I still have those beans and I cannot afford more right now. But I do want to try more local places. So if you have a favorite that I haven't featured yet, it's very, very possible. Please shout it out to me so I can experience something new. But enough of my nonsense, let's get into it. Now in Ohio, the deadline to register to vote is October 5th, and that's just 1 month away. It's super easy to do though, just fill out some information on the Secretary of State's website, and if you believe you are registered, it never hurts to double check. You can confirm that info online as well, and I have links for you in the description of this video, so you are covered, no sweat. Okay, so you're set, you're registered, you're ready to rumble. Let's take a look at all the different ways you can vote in this election, starting with absentee. So both the Ohio and Michigan Secretaries of State are making the first move by sending out absentee ballot request forms to every registered voter. When can you start to see those? Well, Ohioans can get ready for those requests to slide into their mailbox sometime this week. And two more rounds of absentee ballot request forms will be mailed to Ohioans who register to vote sometime before the deadline. If you don't plan to vote absentee, I don't know, use the request form as kindling. But if you do, make sure you fill it out ASAP and send it back either through the mail to your Board of Elections or drop it off in one of those handy designated drop boxes.
The deadline for your request to be received is noon on October 31st. Spooky. But honestly, don't wait that long. And once your request is approved, actual ballots will begin to be sent out on October 6th. Then you fill it out, you send it back, bada bing, bada boom, your vote is in.
Just make sure your ballot is postmarked for either the day before election or you drop it off in the drop box by 7:30 p.m. on election day, which is November 3rd. But let's talk about those drop boxes for a second. Are they safe to use?
Secretary of State Frank LaRose says yes. According to his directive, every day at least one Republican and one Democratic member of the local board or staff retrieve together, hand in hand, the box's contents. Well, maybe they're not holding hands, but it's nice to imagine. Those boxes also have to be monitored 24/7.
And for the first time in a general election, every Ohio county will have one of those. But Ohio Democrats say one isn't enough. In fact, they're suing LaRose, trying to create more drop boxes and accusing him of suppressing Ohio voters. But LaRose said adding more boxes is a fine idea in the future. He just wants to get legislature involved in that process.
But locally, even though we likely won't see more boxes, Lucas County is getting a bigger box to hold all the extra absentee ballots that are expected this year because of the issues with the post office and, you know, Rona. The current drop box can only hold about 500 ballots or envelopes. That new drop box will be able to hold around 3,600, so pretty impressive.
And if you prefer to vote in person but crowds are still weirding you out a bit, maybe voting early would be a good alternative.
For most counties, this just means you go to your Board of Elections, although Lucas and Summit have separate early voting centers. Early voting starts October 6th and goes all the way up until November 2nd. Now, honestly, the hours you can vote in that window seem to vary a bit, but you can check on LaRose's website or just call your BOE.
But if you're more to the stick to the classics type of guy or gal, you still can vote in person on election day, but of course, things might just look a little bit different.
For instance, masks will be required. However, if someone does arrive without a mask, they won't be denied their right to vote. LaRose said they will be offered a mask if they don't have one or encouraged to vote curbside, which is a wild concept to me.
Look, you can vote for president and pick up a sizzling steak from Applebee's all without leaving your sedan like a patriot. But as a reminder, Election Day is November 3rd and polls are open from 6:30 a.m. until 7:30 p.m.
Now, if you are still not 100% sure who you want to vote for in this presidential race, you may gain a little more clarity by watching the debates, with the first one kicking off later this month right here in Ohio. The presidential candidates will first share the stage Tuesday, September 29th at Case Western Reserve University in Cleveland. And a week later, the VP picks will face off Wednesday, October 7th at the University of Utah in Salt Lake City. Biden and Trump will then head to Miami, Florida, where they will debate in a town hall style at Adrian Arsht Center for the Performing Arts, October 15th. And the grand finale of presidential debates will be on October 22nd at Belmont University in Nashville, Tennessee.
And you can watch all of those debates on any major network from 9 until 10:30 p.m. commercial free. But, okay, so we've made our decisions. We've cast our vote. But the big question this year is, when will we actually see those results?
Well, it may not be on election night. For the first time, Ohio Secretary of State Frank LaRose has told county officials to expect up to half of all votes in the presidential election to be sent in by mail. And that's double what we're used to seeing. Only about 20 to 25% of Ohio voters have typically voted by mail in previous presidential election years. And while absentee ballots are able to be processed as they arrive to County Board of Elections offices, that just means they're getting checked in and verified. It's not the same thing as counting the votes they contain. In fact, none of those votes can be tallied until 7:30 p.m. on election night. And as long as those ballots are postmarked by November 2nd, they don't have to arrive until November 13th to be counted. So while that could delay our results, Ohioans can rest assured that as long as your absentee ballot arrives to your county's Board of Elections office by November 13th, it will be counted. And you can make sure of that by tracking both your request and your actual ballots at voteohio.gov.
You know, like you did when you bought that Millennium Falcon replica that cost like $500 when you had too many glasses of wine, except this time it's with the fate of the free world, so. But that is all the time that I have for you today. If you need more information on anything we talked about, including those important links, make sure you check out the link I provided for you in the description of this video, which includes my famous chocolate chip cookie recipe. So let me know if you tried that out. But here's where I'm gonna get a little annoying. If you liked this video, make sure you show that off, take it off to the next level, and you hit that like button. And subscribe to our channel. You'll get an alert whenever we pop on with something super cool. But with all of that being said, I hope you get out there, you make informed decisions, and I'll see you next time.